Good morning, church.
Good morning.
Thank you, Gary.
I'd like to wish everybody that's watching on YouTube or Facebook a happy Mother's Day today. All our mothers here. And I guess what we'll do this morning is, before we even get started in the service, is go ahead and find out who our oldest and youngest is. Is there a mother here that's 40 years old? Is there a mother here that's 50 years old? You over 50?
You know, you're not how old I am, dude.
Is there a mother here that's 52?
No.
53?
No.
51?
Well, you're probably getting there.
All right, come up here.
Or happy Mother's
Day.
All right. Is there a mother here that's where did I start at? Is our mother here? It's 100 years old. Feelings don't count. Is there a mother here that's over 80? Is there a mother here that's 79?
Rosie Bosley, she's the oldest.
When was you born?
October 18th, 1941.
Wow.
That's ancient.
I was gonna say that was a long time ago.
Yeah, that's back during the war.
How old are you, Rosie?
You
were born 41. You were born 41? What month?
December?
Yeah, she's a snow baby and I am too. I was born the 30th.
And you're... You ain't got one. You could have one. You were born in what? April?
October 18th.
Oh, October. Well, I guess you're the oldest mother. Come on up.
This will be the first time I've ever got anything for being old. Never been that old before.
Congratulations. Happy Mother's Day. Now, before we leave, I want all the mothers to come up here and get a picture. Youngest, I want them to come up with the flyers and let me get a picture of them. We won't do it right now, but before we leave,
Daniel, you got a song?
That's not old, late, man.
It's hard to do, and I can't get a laugh like I did when I was in bed. But with that, my faith, I see a brand new body that's waiting for me. I'll be young again when I get over there. I'll be young again when I get to the shore. All the burdens that I have up there, I have to move. No more pain, and I'll never go I'll be young when I get older. These hands are not to fade, and they're shivering, and my steps are getting slow. But I'm as happy as I can be, cause I know what's waiting for me. I'll be young again when I get over there. I'll be young again when I get to heaven shore. All the burdens that I hold up there I'll have to hold. No more heartache, no more pain, and I'll never know again. I'll be young again when I get over there. Yes, I'll be young again when I get over there.
Hey man, I like that song. I'll be young again.
Yeah,
yeah. No walking chains in heaven. No glasses. No hearing aids. No broken down bodies, no bad ribs.
I won't be up high tonight, hurt.
No, no diabetes. No fibromyalgia. No COPD. Won't be up. Won't be no pain, no sorrow. You know, I've heard people say, well, so-and-so's looking down on me. I don't believe that for a minute. But God's not going to let no sorrow in heaven. And if they can look down and see you, they're going to see sorrow. Amen. No sorrow this morning. Amen. Anybody else want to sing? Give a testimony? I just want to thank God, first of all, for saving me. I want to thank you for my wife and my daughter. That means the world to me. They've been times that I didn't show much love for either one of them. But I thank God he forgives us. I feel God every day. And I'm glad to see him every day. Go to him in fire and ask for him. Repent and walk away from him. Amen. If you will, turn with me and the book of Proverbs. Proverbs chapter 31, the last book. Let's all stand for reading God's word. I'm going to start in verse 10, chapter 31. The Bible says, for who can find a virtuous woman? For her price is far above rubies. The heart of her husband doeth safely trust in her, that he shall have no need of the Lord. She will do him good and not evil all the days of her life. She seeketh wool and flax, and worketh willingly with her hands. She is like the merchant ships, She bringeth her food from afar. She riseth also while it is yet night, and giveth meat to her household, and a portion to her maiden. She considereth a field, and buyeth it. With the fruit of her hand she planteth a vineyard. She girdeth her loins with strength, and strengtheneth her arms. She perceiveth that her merchandise is good, her candle goeth not out by night. She layeth her hands to the spindle, and her hands hold the staff. She reacheth out her hand to the poor, yea, she reacheth forth her hands to the needy. She is not afraid of the snow for her household, for all her household are clothed with scarlet. She maketh herself covering of tapestry. Her clothing is silk and purple. Her husband is known in the gates when he sitteth among the elders of the land. She maketh fine linen and selleth it and delivereth girdles unto the merchant. Strength and honor are her clothing, and she shall rejoice in time to come. She openeth her mouth with wisdom, and her tongue is the law of kindness. She looketh well into the ways of her household, and eateth not the bread of idleness. Her children arise up and call her blessed, her husband also, and he praiseth her. Many daughters have done virtuously, but thou excellest them all. Favor is deceitful, and beauty is vain, but a woman that feareth the Lord, she shall be praised. Give her the fruit of her hands, and let her own works praise her in the gate. Our Heavenly Father, Lord, as we come to you this morning, Lord, we're thankful for our gods and mothers that we have here in this church, God. Father, I pray a special blessing for each one of our mothers. God, I pray that you would take this message, Lord, and use it, Lord, to these mothers, Lord, that are to be praised this morning. Father, I wish my mother was here this morning. Father, I'd just give anything if I could just hug her neck and tell her how much I appreciate her and how much I love her. Lord, I know one day, before long, I'll be able to do that. Father, I just pray that you bless this message, Lord. Use it for thy glory. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. A price of a virtuous woman is far above rubies. You know, as we celebrate Mother's Day today, there's a lot of mothers still living in this world. And then, it's sad to say, but there are also moms living in this world today. And I call them moms because I know women had children and walked off and left. How can a mom do it? A mother couldn't do it. She was truly a mother to those children. She couldn't just walk off and leave. A mother is going to make sure that her children's needs are met. A mother going to make sure her husband's needs are met. She's going to put food on the table for her family. You know, a lot of these ladies I know make quilts and stuff, and that's part of taking care of people. when you make quilts and give them to people that you cherish and love, that shows that you're a very special mother. A mother's always praying for her children. I know back when I was a teenager, I mean, I wasn't out drinking or nothing, but I was wild in my own way. You know, I thought I knew everything. I even left home because I knew more than mom and dad did. Of course, it didn't take me long to go back. And I didn't know. But all that time, I had a mom that was praying for me to get back on the right path. Daniel, when you was out drinking, you had a mother at the home praying for you. Man? She never went to sleep, I can guarantee you that. She prayed from the time she laid down to the minute she walked in the door. She would be all right. But you know, I don't really know how to say this, but I believe in the way we live now. We got more moms than we do mothers. Moms don't teach their children about God. Moms won't even stay with their children. At the time, they pack them off on somebody else or just walk off and leave them. They've dead any kids there. Doing for herself. She has no love in her heart for her kids or her husband. That's not a mother. A mother accepts her responsibilities, and she does her responsibilities. Lord, help that person in me. Whether it be fire, wreck, whatever it will do with it, take care of them. I knew when I was young and I was out, I knew I had to make some do when I got home, because it seemed like no matter what I was doing, when I got home, mom knew exactly what I was doing. I mean, I wasn't drinking. You know, she didn't smell no beer on my breath and no whiskey or nothing. But the things I was doing, she knew what I was doing when I got home. Some of the worst whippings I ever got was when I was 5, 6, 10. Because I could walk in and she could tell me exactly what I'd done that entire evening. Now that's a mother's love. If she's that prayed up, if God reveals to her what I've been doing, that's a righteous woman, a virtuous woman. You know, virtuous really means clean. The virtuous woman is also righteous because she's so prayed up. Her and God can talk to each other. And God can reveal things to them. And I think every woman that's sitting in this room today is a virtuous woman. I have no doubt in my mind. My daddy was a was 13 in his family. He had a brother that had 17. I can't imagine a family doing that good. My mom and dad looked at me when I was born, they said, that's it, no more. No, I'll take that back. I had a point. And then my mom lost another later on. But I guess God knew it was a good thing to live. Whatever the reason, I thank God that I'm alive. And I thank God for my prayer and mercy. I do. I wish I could just grab her and hug her and thank her for everything she done for me growing up. Or even after I was married, she still prayed for me. She was a godly woman. Every evening, after supper, she'd sit down in her recliner and she'd reach over and grab her Bible. She would sit there and read our. I can't do that. I can't read to if I open my Bible to study, I study for about 30 minutes. I've got to close it because my mind it won't stay in one place. Of course, when you ain't got much mind, you didn't get that time in your family, would you? But I have to go back because really, I can't study over 30 minutes. I don't know if it's AD, what is it? ADD or what, but I just can't keep my mind in one spot very long at a time. I guess my mind's still used to it. Just to wander off on everything else. I need somebody to show me how to control my mind. Too bad. But you know, I can remember my grandma from Daniel Mother. I'm sure Barbara and Rosa Mother. She was a godly woman. You could go to her house any time of the day. If she wasn't up working, fixing dinner, fixing breakfast, or whatever, just sitting in her chair with me. My grandma and grandpa, I don't think ever had a TV. Now, grandpa did after grandma died when he moved down in the apartments. He bought him a TV. But when they was up on Weaver Creek, I don't think. Now, I may be wrong, but I don't think there was ever a TV in my house. And my grandma, she didn't go to work with her. If a fire was coming to Mercy, or a corn was coming down there, that didn't worry her a bit. That was worldly things. She stayed at home. You know, when Lorraine's husband died, he was a preacher. When he died, she took Lorraine and Gail and took care of him until she died. I mean, Lorraine worked. I mean, she was able to take care of herself. But Grandma took care of Lorraine. She took care of Gail. So Lorraine could work. Grandma kept me, so my mom could work. We lived right across the branch room with our big group. And a little football going across the branch. And every time I'd get sick, first thing come out of my mouth, I went to my grandma. Grandma moved there, across the street, in the house. And she'd sit there with me till I got to feeling that it didn't matter if it was day, it didn't matter if it was week. She'd be there. She was there at my side before I sit. You don't find those like you do these days. grandchildren, and much as she did for her own. She was a virtuous woman. She was worth more than all the siblings of already in this world. And I feel like my mother was the same way. She was a godly woman. I remember when I was little, I was sick a lot when I was little. I've been murdered. She runs with it every time she runs. Every time we go to murder, she was there. Taking care of him. She had that motherly love. She knew mom and dad. She knew me. Every time I go to the hospital, she was there. Taking care of him. She was there. The hospital was there. Everybody, I believe that's all my heart. And I don't know what Ola did when she was working. I don't know what Louise did. I know where you was at. You was Levi's. You was making sure people had clothes today. Amen. And I'm sure you put love in what you did. You know, the worst thing to me that I can hear is people complaining about their job. You know, people ought to be thankful if they got a job. I always try to be thankful when I have a job. Well, I complain a lot. I'll be honest with you. But now that I'm where I can't work, it bothers me to hear somebody complaining about a job. Because they're just like I was. I took my job for granted a lot. And I'm sure these mothers had a different approach to their job. They loved their job. And whatever was they done, I don't know, they could have been a seamstress in a sewing plant or whatever, a nurse in a hospital. But every job has meaning to it. I was a truck driver for over 10 years. I took food to warehouses, brought them to the stores. For about a year, I hauled fresh flowers from California to different ports so that people could give them to their mothers. People could give them to people that died. There was meaning in that job. And at the time, I didn't think of it. Don't think on my mind when I was driving the truck getting that paycheck. But it was good money. And then I was a janitor in the nursing home that year. That meant something because I was keeping the place clean for the patient. I was doing something to help them out. And a lot of people think, well, I'm just a janitor. But that job's important. Them people, bad the way is. They need to have clean floors to walk on. They need to have that restroom sanitized daily so they don't catch nothing. Usually nursing homes, four beds in two different rooms and they all share the same bathroom. And you've got to keep the bathroom sanitized. But a woman, I think, has more compassion about their job than a man. They take the They go the extra mile. And a woman that prays for her children. A woman that brings them up the way they ought to be brought up. Teaching them about God. Teaching them right from wrong. That's a mother's love. And there's nothing no sweeter than a mother's love. You know, daddies can love their children. But I guarantee you, you ask any child who they love the most, they would say, "Mom." I hear about this all the time, about love, many ones she does, "Mom." All right, she was always, "I love Mama, Mom." A mama bonds with her children. Mother bonds with her children. Their children in this whole world. And how these young girls can have babies and not take care of them, don't teach them about God, and a lot of them just walk off and leave them. Okay. Never goes to see them, never has nothing to do with them. I can't understand them. First of all, they need God in their own mind. If they had God in their own mind, they wouldn't be doing it. But this is a special day for mothers. I wish my message would have been longer. But I appreciate and I try to honor mothers. But mothers are a very valuable gift. I mean, back in the day, you could look at every woman that was married and had a kid and call her a mother. You can't do that anymore. Because these young kids go out and have babies. They don't take care of them. They don't pray for them. They don't teach them right from wrong. They don't teach them about God. That's not a mother. Mother's love is special. Now, I love my daddy. Love him with all my heart. Always did. And me and him was never close to any woman. Every time I was outside and I got hurt, seen a snake. I didn't run the daddy, I run the mama. Always run the mama. Mama had those arms of passion. She could hug me and it just seemed like the whole world was good itself. We had no trouble, no heartaches, no life with mama. Daddy always tried to get me to go. He was I don't like to call him a devilish man, but he liked to have fun. When I was 12 years old, he'd give me a cigarette and go around behind the house and smoke. And Mama was kidding. And then he just sat back and laughed. She ought to be spanking him. He's the one that got me started. But like I say, there's nothing more precious than the mother's love. That's the message this morning. I hope you've got something out of it. And I pray this morning that every one of you is a very special day. This is your day. Set aside one. I hope we've done it. If we ain't, let me know. You know what I need. it's getting better.